we should know how to handle, not only how to handle the success, how to handle the failures. Particularly you are in the management environment, I want the young people to understand how to manage the failure. Because any task you do, you have to come across problem. Problem should not become the captain of the individual or the project chief. The project chief should become the captain of the problems and defeat the problem and succeed. Learning gives creativity. Creativity leads to thinking. Thinking provides knowledge. Knowledge makes you great.
History has proven that those who dare to imagine the impossible are the ones who break all the human limitations. In every field of human endeavor, whether science, medicine, sports, arts or technology, the names of the people who imagine the impossible are engraved in our history. By breaking the limits of their imagination, they change the world. You take C.V. Raman, you take Newton, you take Einstein, you take Chandrasekhar, by breaking the limits of their imagination, they change the world. If you want to be discoverers, if you want to be innovators, I am going to give you what type of characteristic you must have. Invention and discoveries have emanated from creative minds that have been constantly working and imagining the outcome. The telephone, he was imagining the outcome in the mind. With imaging and constant effort, all the forces of the universe work for that inspired mind, thereby leading to invention, discoveries.
Sir, I would like to hear from you a few tips for the upcoming generation to succeed in life.
Well, succeeding in life, I have already told you.
Yes, sir.
You have to do 4 things, okay? Number one, great aim.
Great aim.
I will have great aim.
I will
continuously acquire knowledge. I will do hard work. I will persevere
and succeed.
Okay, that's the mantra.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
You have many accomplishments. You've written books. You've served as president. You're an aerospace engineer. You've been a professor. But you say the title you like best is the title of teacher. Why is that?
You know, I had a teacher when I was a young boy, 10 years boy, wartime, the Second World War going on. At that time, I used to see in my class, fifth class teacher, in science teacher, he entered the classroom. And we used to see the radiation of knowledge from him. When he enters the classroom, my teacher, I see radiation of purity of life. And the way he taught, my dream got shaped. What should be my way of life? He is the person, the teacher, gave me the vision of my life when I was a young fellow. Now, teacher has got a fantastic opportunity to grow minds, to enrich the minds, and give the dreams to the young people, and nurture the dreams with them, and they will become a great human being. Sometime they will become better than you, but better than the teacher. So that opportunity you have. I will have great aim. I will continuously acquire knowledge. Oh, I will do hard work. I will persevere and succeed.
Great lesson, of which no university taught me, no book taught me, but that one person, that institution, hospital taught me such a big lesson.
How to manage success, most importantly, the failure.
How to live a good life, how to live a beautiful life without thinking which country you belong, without thinking which religion you belong, without thinking which language you belong, without thinking which caste you belong. To represent the indomitable spirit of a man. Wherever there is indomitable spirit of man, the man succeeds, the woman succeeds, the village succeeds, the state succeeds, the country succeeds, the world succeeds. The indomitable spirit. Sri Dhirubhai Ambani has a mission and a great entrepreneur who had seen successes. For success, any mission, what we need is indomitable spirit. Let us study the characteristics of an indomitable spirit. It has two components. Indomitable spirit has got two components. The first component is that there must be a vision leading to higher goals of achievement. I would like to recall a couplet, the Thirukkural, by the poet Saint Thiruvalluvar, written in 2000 years ago. It means that whatever may be the depth of the river or lake or pond, whatever they may be the conditions of the water, the lily flower always comes out of the and blossoms. Similarly, if there is a definite determination to achieve a goal, even if it is impossible to achieve, the man succeeds. This is one of the component of the indomitable spirit. The second one, that many of us have gone through large programs and projects. We would have experienced the success is not in sight and there are many hurdles. Hurdles created by man, hurdle created by the nature of the program, hurdle created by the technology, all this impossible in a major program like what wealth generation. It means that successful leaders can never be defeated by problems. They become the master of the situation and they defeat the problems. Now friends, the indomitable spirit is defined by these two conditions. I consider these two Thirukkurals characteristics characterize the indomitable spirit of Dhirubhai Ambani. Whenever he encountered problems, he gave the problems to the problems. He inhibited the indomitable spirit in successfully implementing the complex missions. Growth is life. I have repeated a number of times, I don't mind repeating that one incident. That incident for me is a university education. I have not read anywhere. I have so far, I have gone around the orbit 71 times around the sun. I have not gone through any education, such a beautiful education I got in 1979-1980 period. I thought of sharing with you on this occasion. It is like this, 1979, August 17th, we were ready for launch of a satellite launch vehicle with 44 subsystems and thousands of components. It was built in Vikram Sarabhai Space Center, and at that time, Professor Satish Dhawan was the chairman of Atomic Energy Space Commission, and he is also Space Center. And he gave me the task in 1973 to build a satellite launch vehicle, to put the satellite in the orbit. 1973, he gave me this task. In 79, we were ready. Thousands of engineers, 10,000 of workers and staff, they all worked together. Then we moved the satellite launch vehicle from Vikram Sarabhai Space Center to the now Satish Dhawan Space Center at Sriharikota. So the launch vehicle was in the launch pad, and that day, 17th August 1979, and I am the mission director, project director, and we are all in the control center, and computer takes over. Up T-minus 8 minutes, computer will take over, because very difficult for me as a mission director to check hundreds of parameters. So it has to be checked. Computer, we hand over the whole launch of the rocket system to the computer. So when T-minus 8 minutes came, I handed over to the computer for the launch on 17th August 1979. And thousands of people are waiting for the launch mission centers, and they are working throughout the country and some downrange stations. Exactly at T-minus 8 minutes, computer took over. And then at T-minus 4 minutes, computer put a hold. It says, don't launch. So we are all, because at that time, the whole rocket system alive, and every explosive system, propellant system, electronic system, all are on, ready to launch. Computer says, don't launch. At T-minus 4 minutes, then immediately a computer printout comes out. There's some problem in the second stage control system. There's a leakage, so you don't launch. Behind me, there are number of experts, 6-7 experts, my expert 10 years, 20 years experienced people. I turn to them, and they are their computers to find out what happened, and they tell me within a minute, they say there's a problem in the second stage control system and we cannot launch. Computer says, but we believe as experts, the igniter, that is oxidizer, is sufficiently more there, even though there's a leakage in the system, you can launch. They asked me to launch. That is, I can say to the computer, to shut off the computer, I can manually launch the rocket system. I discussed with my experts, I believed in them, I agreed with them, I'm responsible for it. I immediately put the rocket in the manual mode. So rocket took off, 100 seconds, beautiful launch, and the rocket first stage did its job. It's a 4-stage rocket system. Then the second stage took off. Within a minute, within a second, it got into spin. That means it should be steady. It's a controlled rocket system by a guidance system. But it was going to spin. I knew I lost the rocket system. Within few seconds, instead of putting the satellite in the orbit, the whole system went to Bay of Bengal. So it was a failure. And then how do you handle a failure? It's very important for entrepreneurs. Life is not so simple. We have to handle the failures with stout heart. My chairman, that is the Professor Satish Dhawan, exactly at 6:30, I was very tired of continuously working. He come to my room, you join me for a press conference. On that day, press con, the morning, there's a press conference. Hundreds of press reporters, media people have assembled. Just Professor Dhawan told me, Satish Dhawan told me, I am going to handle the press conference. You are going to come with me. He took me there. And there was a press, the national press, international press. They asked a lot of questions. How can you put 20 crores in Bay of Bengal, one guy asked. And like that, so many serious questions. After all, people will ask questions, the people's money. So like that, number of questions were there. And Professor Satish Dhawan said, yes, it's a failure. First time we have launched, we have gained a lot of system, and definitely we will succeed. I'll give all the support to my technologies. I'll give all the support to my scientists. We will succeed in a year's time, he said. Friends, did you observe what happened there? I am the mission director. I am the project director. I have failed the missions. With me, 5,000 people have worked. But chairman Indian Space Research Organization, he took the responsibility of the failure. He completely switched my failure to his failure. This is the leadership quality. Exactly after 1 year, that is 18th July 1980, we go to the launch pad and the countdown starts. T-minus 8 minutes, I hand over to the computer. Computer checks out. First stage, it initiates the rocket system. First stage gives the required velocity. Second stage gives the required velocity. Third stage gives the required velocity. And fourth stage required the escape velocity for the put the satellite in the orbit. I am seeing in front of me how, what is the performance taking place. I took the microscope, I put the mic, I announced all the station. Here is your mission director. The satellite is in the orbit and we congratulate you, I told them. No, that's not the important, that's one of the important things happened. But after 30 minutes, Vikram and Satish Dhawan called me. Go for press conference, you conduct the press conference, he said. Can you see the significance? Failure he took it, success he gave me to my team. This is a great lesson. It's a great lesson. This is a great lesson of which no university taught me, no book taught me, but that one person, that institution that taught me such a big lesson.
We say in India, where there is righteousness in the heart, where there is righteousness in the heart, there is beauty in the character. When there is beauty in the character, there is harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there is an order in the nation. When there is order in the nation, there is peace in the world.
Every action of the leader should be transparent. You know what I mean? That is, leader should work with integrity and succeed with integrity. Leader should work with integrity and succeed with integrity. So if we use and make somebody's life happy, that is, you are giving and his or her life is happy, that's a better, best thing a human being can think of. That then you'll get a conflict-free world. And I believe president, since you asked the question, has to be continuously in touch with the people. I have a feeling whenever I give something, I feel happy. You see, this is you try. That whatever you may have knowledge, you have sometimes better economy you may have, better maybe sometimes you have a kind words you can have.
Sir, how did you become so great?
How did I become so great? That's the question. Well, I don't know how became. I don't know. You know, in the relative terms. So I personally believe you must have a dream. Say, I must have a dream. I must continuously acquire knowledge.
I must continuously acquire knowledge.
Hard work.
And perseverance.
Not afraid of problems. Then you'll be successful. Okay?
What did I learn from the youth of 11 million people? I learned every youth wants to be unique. Every youth wants to be unique. That is you. Every youth wants to be unique. That is you. But the world around you is doing its best day and night to make you just everybody else. Question is whether you want to be you or everybody else. You want to be you, not everybody else. Now, if the question being like everybody else is convenient, at the first glance, but not satisfying in the long vision. The challenge, therefore, my young friends, is that you have to fight the hardest battle. You have to fight the hardest battle which any human being can ever imagine to fight, and never stop fighting until you arrive at your destined place. That is the unique view.